Hello dear children, welcome to the EVS class. Before we start with our topic, just answer me a few questions. What's this? A computer? And how does it work? It works with the help of its parts like monitor, keyboard, mouse, etc. Similarly, what's this? It's a human body. And how does it work? It works with the help of different organs. Like eyes, nose, hands, heart, brain, lungs, etc. So what's the topic for today? It's our body. So by the end of this chapter, you will be able to differentiate between external organs and internal organs and study in detail about internal organs. So let's start. There are two types of organs in the human body. What are they? External organs and internal organs. Just look at this picture. The organs which are present on the left hand side, these all you have seen these organs. Why? Since they are present outside your body. So you have seen them. Therefore they are called external. And just look at these organs which are on the right hand side. Like your brain, your lungs, your heart, you have never seen these organs. You have just seen their picture or videos. Because they are present inside the body. So they can be seen only when the body is cut open. So coming back to the topic, let's differentiate. External organs, they are present outside the body, and internal inside the body. External can be seen easily, whereas internal they can be seen only when the body is cut open. External organs, they take rest when we sleep, whereas internal organs, they work all the time, even when we are sleeping. Example of external is eyes, ears, nose, etc. And internal is heart, lungs, kidney, etc. The first organ which we are going to study is heart. It is a red-brown colored muscular organ and it pumps blood to all the parts of the body. It is approximately the size of your fist. Fist means when the fingers are folded inside your palm, it forms a fist. It during the normal condition beats 72 times a minute, and when you exercise or run, it beats faster. If you wish to feel your heartbeat, you can just keep your hand on the left side of chest and you can feel the heartbeat. Now heart doesn't work alone. It has team, and the team members are blood vessels. There are mainly two types of blood vessels in the body, arteries and veins. Arteries, they appear red in color, whereas veins, they appear blue in color. Arteries are thick walled, whereas veins are thin walled. Arteries carry pure blood, that means oxygenated blood, blood rich in oxygen, from heart to different parts of the body. Whereas veins, they will carry impure blood, that is blood which has more of carbon dioxide, from the body to heart. Arteries, this blood contains digested food, water and oxygen, whereas veins, this blood contains carbon dioxide. Now the next organ which we are going to study is brain. Now where is brain present? It is present inside our head. It is also a soft and delicate organ which is protected by the skull. It controls all the activities of our body. Anything, any activity, whatever you do, whether writing, talking to someone or anything, all the things are being controlled by brain. So it acts like a supercomputer. Now brain also has a team, and the team members are large number of nerves which run through the whole body. Our sense organs send messages to the brain. The brain receives the messages and sends out signals through thread-like structures called nerves to different body parts. Now brain also needs a continuous supply of blood and oxygen to function. And from where does it gets this blood and oxygen? It gets it from the heart. Just in the previous slide, we have learned that heart pumps blood. So to brain also, heart is pumping the blood and then only it is working. So our internal organs or external, whatever they are, organs are interdependent and interconnected upon each other. That was all for today's class. Thank you.